Nah.
Yo, it's your boy. You're a pony. You know, we only really know him from like Billy Joe Saunders, right? Like, what do you really know about him? What kind of fight are you expecting?
I'm expecting him to bring his A game. He's fighting for a world title. And at the end of the day, that's what I would be doing if I was fighting for, I had an opportunity to fight for a world title. Yeah, what do we know about him? That he fought Billy Joe Saunders, went 12 rounds, and he made Billy Joe Saunders not look good. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, we're not looking to fight tomato cans or people that's just going to lay down, like Rocky Fielding or shit like that. You know, not, well, let me get in position. It has to be enough of that, man. Like, yeah, people, the fans, the reporters, it's like, yo, when's enough? When are we going to see really, when are we really going to see two fighters that we want to see go at it? And, you know, I think it's starting to happen now. Derevchenko versus Danny Jacob is a fight that needed to happen, you know. And I was going to fight Billy Joe Saunders, but he caught on drugs doing his thing. And I'm coming off a year layoff, so I mean, it must be a bad man if you want to get on drugs. And I'm just looking to put everybody else out their misery in the top 10. So when they go and look to see who can we fight next, it's like, damn, Demetrius just fucked everybody up. Like,
yeah.
You've never been shy about saying how you feel. You just spoke about it. Rocky Fieldings, etc. Canelo's gotten a lot of credit now. They're saying he might be in the mix for a round three with Triple G. What do you think about that? I mean, I feel like it's been 50-50. The fans are kind of like, oh, we don't want to see it again. How do you feel about that? Are you just running dry?
Yeah, I mean, it is not near Arturo Gatti and Mickey Ward, man. Like, we're not seeing that. So it's like, dude, what's the point? Either way, because of how the shit works, you're just going to be like, FIFA la Mexico, the winner. You know what I'm saying? Or a draw again. Yeah. Like, that's what we're going to see. Triple G's coming. He's getting older, you know, at the same time. And so they should have winged twice, man. Let it be. If Triple G's looking to get back in the ring, there's Danny, there's me. And the winner can fight Canelo Canelo Demetrius, Canelo Danny, Demetrius Triple G, like there's lineups that could be made by the end of this year.
You know, I bring it out because like we've seen you fight these types of fights before. You know what I'm saying? Like I've seen you as a world champion and I've seen you fight, you know, guys like you're about to fight on Friday. And I've seen you as Canelo's mandatory at 54 and he screwed it up to 60. You know what I'm saying? So what's really gonna have to happen for you to get one of these marquee fights?
It's like I was just explaining to you guys, you know, I got to destroy everybody else that's in the top 10, top 15. So when they look at the ratings, it's like, yo, Demetrius, be him, because I'm trying to be more active than these guys. Canelo's probably just going to do maybe one, two fights this year. I'm going to try to do three. You know, I'm going to try to get them out of there. So, and then, you know, Danny Jacobs going to probably do the same. So it's like, yo, who are you guys left to fight? At the end of the day, the marquee names are the guys I'm mentioning because, you know, there was no Cotto for me. There was no Sugar Shane Mosley for me. You know, there ain't no Austin Trout for me. I fought him in the amateurs, but this is, like, you know, the out with the old and with the new. There is no, who's old? Who's old? Right now at the 160 pound, other than Triple G right now, who else is a guy that's going to be, like, on his way out that I can fight?
It would be Lemieux, but he can't make 60 anymore. So.
I think anybody watching this interview who didn't know Demetrius Andre will be under the impression that you were just a contender. You're the champion talking about having to fight guys in the top 10 to just to fight other champions when it should be the other way around. Guys should want to unify with you, right? You still have that underdog attitude?
Of course, you know, I'm not satisfied because I have a belt.
A lot of guys are.
Yeah, of course. Three times, I guess. You know, two times, whatever. You know, I believe that I'm the most talented, I have the most charisma. I am, like, a guy that can do many things, and I represent boxing well, I believe. And it's just time for people to really see what they've been missing. It's not Canelo. It's not Triple G. It's Demetrius Andre. Like, and if you go back, 2008 Olympian, I beat everybody, like, that's you guys know today, Keith Thurman, Sean Porter, Danny Jacob, Austin Trout, and whoever else wants to come up, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'll whoop their asses too. But, you know, at the end of the day, the short end of the stick. I'm going to keep it how it is, short end of the stick, because I didn't have the best machine behind me, moving me, to put me in a position to fight a Cotto. Kermit Citron, or you know, these guys. I've been asking for these guys for a long time, but it's like, you know, if the people can't put me in there, when no, they can't, there's nothing I can do.
So. You weren't shy at the dais. You said 154, 160, 168. Does that mean, hey, if Jared Hurd wants to fight Boo Boo, you're fighting him at 54?
Yeah, nah, 60.
60.
60. They have to come out. I'm going back down to 54. I was at 54 at one time.
Okay, so the 54 pounders got to come up and see you.
Yeah, of course.
68 pounders, though. You're open to that
up.
Idea?
Yeah, I'll go up.
Okay.
You know, see if there's any more Rocky Fieldings up there. You know, what I'm you know, see how you guys like
it. Is it only for the Rocky Fieldings? Or what about like a guy like Caleb Plant who just won?
Nah, I mean, Caleb's my boy. You all right. Know what I'm saying? I don't know, but.
I know you guys are Team Snack and everything.
I'm not going to give out the goods too early. I'm going to go ahead and, you know, do what I have to do Friday, and then we can talk about, you know, the future or what I think that would be good, a great matchup or a better matchup than a lot of these other fighters are doing.
I don't know if you've put your response out there yet, but the Charlos had just fought. We know you guys have history. One Charlo lost, one Charlo won. Some people fought. Even the bigger Charlo at 160 had a tough fight. What were your thoughts on that? Now people are looking at you
I guess
like...
You guys see the true talent, you know what I'm saying, at the end of the day. And when you get in there with somebody that wants to win or is a live person, well, you got what you've seen. Corbav is what, 40 years old? I don't know. I'm just saying. Tony Harris.
Southpaw as well. I mean, did you see something like, okay, I'm the elite southpaw of the division who's also the master technician?
I already knew I could beat these guys. It's a matter of time of getting in the ring. I'm more mature than I was before, and I've been in the ring with the top guys, and either sparring or fighting them. And my progress keeps growing. I look better every time. You know, they're like, what? I fought Willie Nelson, right?
Gosh, we gotta take it out.
Pumbled him, right? That's my boy, pumbled him.
I think you're a victim of your own talent. I think you're too good. Like, you know what I mean? You're so good, people want to fight you.
That's fucked up. That's not how the world works, though. Shouldn't you want to fight the guy that's good? Like, yo, I'm going to go fight Mike Tyson because he's on the video game, Mike Tyson Punch Out. I'm working my way up to fuck him up, right?
Jamal had a lot to say about Snack and Willie Monroe. Did you feel any kind of way about that?
You know, Willie did what he did, and Victor is making sure that, you know, I'm clean, of course. Danny Jacobs clean. If you're not in his camp, you do something somewhere else, how's that fall on you? If your dad says make sure you wear rubber when you're getting some, and you don't, you go blame your dad.
Thanks for clearing that up, brother. Thank you.